So it looked like you were having a little bit of fun out there. It started right from the beginning. What were you trying to show, and how did things end up getting into that kind of rhythm for you?
I mean, I know that I can play basketball. I believe in myself. So, I mean, I'm just, once I start making shots early, I knew it was going to be a good night. And just teammates giving me confidence, coaches giving me confidence. And guys making shots makes it a lot easier. You know, when I make shots and then I make good passes and good decisions, and those guys get buckets too, like they make, it just makes the game a lot more free-flowing. The defense is off balance. It's just really easy to get going. And we found a groove early and just kind of rode that the first half.
All right, so you start 4-for-4 from three, and on a couple of them, you looked over to the bench, you saw Ingram's going nuts, Lonzo Ball's going nuts. Yeah. So that, what was the interplay like for you there?
We've been together a week, and we have really good team chemistry. You know, everybody kind of hypes each other up when someone gets going. The other night, it was Brandon the first game. Second game, it was Lonzo. We started going a little bit. And tonight, it just happened to be my night. And, you know, that's the NBA in a nutshell, you know. Every night's going to be a different guy. You're going to have your stars, and then there's going to be guys that step up and play big, and I just try to fill those shoes tonight.
So you led the way in building that 28-point lead, and the crowd was going nuts, and then they come all the way back. Crunch time, it's kind of back and forth. What were you seeing out there in crunch time?
I was just trying to make the right decision. I was a little fatigued, so I tried to get off the ball and let Vander get going. He was getting to the paint and making some good decisions, so we tried to let him kind of finish the game. That's what he does. He's an instant offense kind of guy. So we knew he had that. And then David came up with a big stop on Buddy late in the game, forced an air ball. So really just trying to make plays. You know, we had other guys step up late. I tried to get us going early, and then they finished the job.
You know, you mentioned that this has been something that's you have confidence in your own game. Mm-hmm. But to show it on this level with everybody watching on NBA TV and stuff, it did it after the game now. Does that feel a little different for you?
I mean, I'm proud of myself, obviously, that I came out and performed like I did. But, I mean, I've been playing high-level basketball since college, and obviously it's a much different level with much better players. But, I mean, 90% of the guys that I saw on the court tonight I've played against, I've seen play before. You know, we've mixed and mingled. So, you know, it's not a lack of confidence or a fear of playing against them because you're on the stage now. You know, it's just, all right, we're here to play basketball. I lace my shoes up just like they do, get ready to play.
You obviously don't belong to the Lakers minor league system yet, so did you put a little bit of pressure on them to, if they want to keep you, you know, they're going to have to sign you to?
I mean, that's what summer league's about, you know. It's about finding a team that's willing to give you an opportunity and taking advantage of it. And, I mean, this is stories like this game right here is what summer league's about. And I'm just happy that I was given the opportunity and then I took advantage of it.
Judd said you guys doused him after the win.
I wasn't in there. They did it without me. I was talking to somebody on the court. I'm a little mad, but yeah, I guess they gave him a nice ice bath on his first summer league career win, I guess.
What's he been like as a coach?
Just real positive, you know. You know, Judd's been really good about keeping the guys as a unit, just really preaching team basketball, and I think that showed tonight with a couple of groups on the court. We had a really good flow, really good chemistry, and we were kind of playing for each other. And like I said earlier, I mean, we've been together a week and we have pretty good chemistry. That's rare in summer league. So I think we just feed off that and just have fun playing with each other.
Alex, did you check your phone for number of messages yet?
Yeah, I scrolled through my phone. There's a lot of random Laker fans that are like commenting on pictures and stuff on Instagram. I'm trying to weed through that and talk to my family and my friends before I get and look at all that. But yeah, it was blowing up pretty much.
It's a play with someone like David Nwaba that's so good at cutting to the basket and, you know, getting to open space.
Ton of fun. I played against David when he was doing his stint with the defenders before he got called up last year, and he gave us like 20 and 20, and I don't think they ran a single play for him the whole game. That's the type of player he is. I love guys like that. They make the team better. He works hard on defense, energy plays. It's really easy to play with guys like that.
Last question, any guess on the number of texts that came in?
I couldn't tell you, man. It was a lot. I scrolled a couple of times. Yeah, it was a lot.